In the old Universal Analytics, we used to have a funnel visualization report that was quite useful. And so essentially it was under conversion, goals, and then funnel visualization, where I could see how many people went through each and every step of the funnel, and therefore computing whether there were some bottlenecks that could prevent people from completing the reservations. Now, in GA4, the situation is slightly different, but we have a similar tool. So let's go back to GA4, and then by default, we don't have anything, so we will need to create it ourselves. So again, let's go into the Explore section, and then we can already create, instead of a blank report, a funnel exploration. This will give us already the setup of a funnel report, and so it's going to be easier to create. It already comes with some pre-templated, predefined steps or labels or events for each and every step of the funnel. Now, of course, we will need to set that up. However, in order to properly set up this report, we will need to instruct the GA4 to take the right event name for each and every step. And so before getting into it, let's go back into reports and then see what kind of events we have in our list. And so engagement, events, let's scroll down. Let's actually include more events. And so this is basically the list of events. And so you can see already some events, the most important one being purchase. We can see begin checkout, we can see add to cart. I'm reverse engineering actually what is the final result of a booking, starting from the last event and then before the begin checkout, where eventually users are asked to enter their personal and credit card details, and then add to cart, and then view item list, and then booking search, and then all other event. Now, needless to say that you must have this event being tracked through your booking engine in GA4. This, of course, depends on each and every booking engine. There are booking engines that can do that by default, that do that by default. For some other booking engines, you will need to do it. So you will need to actually create the tracking first so that you can have this event being listed in here. This is, of course, no tutorial on how to have this tracking set up. Also, because, again, we can have so many different booking engines. But in this case, we have the events that we need. And so now let's move back onto the Explorer. And let's create our report, our funnel report. Let's get back into the funnel report that I opened up before. And now here in the steps, we want to create our single steps. Now we can actually modify what we had first, but what I usually like to do is to have the first open visit being untouched. And this is because it will compute as a first step the total number of users, no matter how many times they come back. I want to compute eventually the conversion rate for each and every user, not for each and every session. And so this step remains untouched. And then the second step, maybe we can do booking search. And so we open here the option, we go onto the event section, and we see booking search, the corresponding event that we want to pull in as the second step of the funnel. And then we can move forward again. What's the third step? The third step is the search availability, or let's say the view availability, or let's call it rooms and rates, meaning the steps where rooms and rates. This is actually the step where people are presented with all available rooms and rates for the given period. So booking search is where they make the search, and then I have these other events, view item list, which is the list of events, the list of rooms and rates that are available for the given period. And then step four, in this case, is very simple, is purchase. Let's leave it there and let's add some step before, add step. Above, sorry, it was my mistake. Remove it, add step below, and then maybe we can have add to cart. This is typically the step when people select one of the available rooms and rates options, add to cart, and then let's select another event, add step below, and then begin checkout. Events and begin checkout. You see the events in the list are automatically listed. These are all the events that have been tracked in any given period. And so we can only select them. And so that's why you will need to have the tracking in place first in order to set up the funnel. The last step of the funnel is purchases automatically provided. So we don't need to put anything or to change anything. And so we can simply apply. Here we already have a summary of everything that happened. and what the final result can be, but let's apply that first. Now here we already have a split by device category, for example. Let's remove them, and we're going to add it later, because first we want to see what's the total result. And so we see that we got this many users who in this given time have opened up the website, any given page of the website, and out of those numbers, these many people actually started a booking search. And so corresponding rate is going to be the 35%. This is another way of computing the CTR, which we have seen in another video. When we look at a funnel, the most important thing that we will need to consider is this 34.21%. In this specific case for this hotel is extremely good. It computes how many people move from the rooms and rates to the add to cart. And the reason why that's important is because, of course, in this step, people are presented with all available options. Based on my experience, the optimal goal would be to reach a 30%. Or at least 25%. In this case, we're going over, so which is extremely good. Most of the times, I do see instead performance being lower than 20%, which means eventually there is something either on a distribution or revenue level that is not necessarily good. And so especially on a distribution level, it may simply mean that people may find better deals somewhere else as opposed to the booking engine. Another very important step is the completion rate between the checkout and the purchase. In this case, it's almost 60%, which is very, very good. Sometimes I do see results like 30% or probably even 20%. It means that the checkout process has been made difficult. For example, people may be asked too many questions in order to complete the booking. Like asking a full address as to where people live is probably not of paramount importance. Or probably the booking policies are not very clear, like guarantee policies or payment policies, and so people may get skeptical and therefore bounce. Now we're looking at a funnel on a very general level, but of course then you can pull in as many dimensions as you want or break down the report by any dimension that you want. Like I said, eventually the mobile devices as opposed to desktop devices, or eventually you can do it by country. And so for example, you might decide to create some geo-targeted offers or packages in order to entice people from that specific country to book further. Again, these are just examples, but you need to get a starting point in terms of initiatives that you might want to put forth in order to get better performance.